Hello, so we didn't get a lot of new stuff since the last boss I did. It's basically the same, only that we have an extra skill points into the minions. No, that's really creepy. Okay, let's go and watch the cutscene, maybe
Welcome to
kill the
our personal
boss.
chamber, honored guest. It is here that our creator, Astaroth the Aberrant, created us, so that we could bestow his gift on Cordenor. Please do offer your organic mass. You will be part of something much greater.
Sorry to disappoint, Lambak, but it will have to be a no. You said you knew where the
We did not like the previous bearer of the artifact. The relic you want joined the Wii.
You ate it? Oh, come on, la.
I bet it was delicious. Maybe next time. This was much better than when I did it with my warrior. The warrior actually
Either
had to dodge,
dead,
jump.
Or it's really pissed off.
Why not both? It's dead and very angry. And also, this is the true form of the Lambak, which was always a surprise to me because it looks like it's a huge entity, the way it should be. You'll float down too. You'll float too. Looks like it doesn't damage my zombies too badly. I remember now I hated this. He's very hard to damage because he has a lot of unvulnerable phases. Okay, he's only attacking the big guy, my golem, which is great. Okay, I need to heal fast. Okay, we're safe now. Almost. circle is so tiny. No, this is stupid. The circle is so tiny and there are a lot of minions. Oh, hold space, I was holding X. Why, thank you, Lambak. You're also flattered. Charming.
Farewell, Lambak.
See you next time. Now let me get my grail. Or whatever it was called.
Finally. This better be worth it.
Okay, we fought the flesh creatures and let's see the loot. I mean, the loot is not great. I think the main problem with this boss fight, oh, look at that. The worms are still alive. Oh, really? I never looked into the hole, but looks like the hole is actually disgusting. Anyway, the biggest problem with the fight is that you have to step into those areas where you couldn't be damaged, so you have to move around. And as you saw, the little circle is so little and I had to kill so many big guys. Yeah, I probably should have focused on killing his minions first and then him, but it worked. And we only died once, and sadly that kind of ruins our achievement, but doesn't matter. The problem is always with the loot. The loot will always be a bigger problem than, you know, the developers would like to admit it, but look at this. Shield, 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 hammer. What can I use from here? Well, nothing, unless I plan to make ski boards out of the shields. Okay, let's do a little bit of story and let's see the other area. I'll play for 5 minutes more and that's about it. And the items you get are not even that expensive, and this was a mission boss. Nah, not really. I don't need more defensive items. I need something with a lot more offensive power. Okay, that was the second attack boss.
No other way.
The more you resist our prayers, the longer it will take for you to heal.
I forgot she's being killed. Anyway, the funny part is that the next boss will actually be a lot more challenging and a lot tougher. But I think by then we'll have a lot more power as well. I mean, I'm basically wearing a lot of stuff for movement speed right now. So not much, but I don't think I need more than this.
I got the first piece of the heli.
Impressive. I told you.
We almost died back there.
I'm getting better. Thanks to their witchcraft.
Unfortunately, resting isn't an option.
You're quick to speak of war for a man that was recently...
We ascended are gifted with imbued resilience.
So I hear.
Still, it will take more...
How do you even know the conflux of energy?
When my order first saw the signs of...
You were part of the Brotherhood operation?
We didn't attack it. We wanted to approach the strange structure. However, when we arrived, the monolith activated. Demonic spawns of fury started. I managed to escape due to my abilities, but Crimson Keep fell to the pacification soon after, now protecting the ritual place and Araman's coming.
Crimson Keep? We used to hear rumors about it, about this...
Yeah, it checks out.
Well, we know.
Okay, now let's pick a road. Oh, I could have used the... I could have transformed and actually saved my continuity. I mean, I think there was an achievement for getting to level 50 without dying, ah well. Doesn't really matter, so let's see what we have over here. This is the legendary stuff. Spell damage. Okay, so this is the one that probably I will take because... 15% spell damage, that's a lot of good stuff. So So this is health, but I don't really think I will die too much. Shield, meh, not really. Critical chance score, spell. We will take this one. So the campaign reward is much better than the boss reward. Okay, let's go over there. I love the cinematic so much. They could make an entire movie out of this game and you will not see much of a difference. I mean, yeah, they only have to change a little bit of the dialogue. Maybe some of the camera angles, but it would make a great movie. I mean, I'm only playing this because of the great art style it has and, you know, because it's a nice RPG and people still want to say it's an action RPG. Well, it is an action RPG, but it's not one of those things like Path of Exile, Diablo. It's slipping my mind the name of the other one. Something with D, I think? Or any of those games that are meant to be played over and over with seasons, with rewards and great multiplayer. I always view this as a single player RPG. I mean, even Diablo 2 had a lot of multiplayer, but this one just didn't fit in because this is a lot of work. I think they worked on the art for so long and for the mechanics and for all the skills that they didn't have time to test anything. They just released it as it was. And after playing Cyberpunk, I'm definitely amazed at how good the game is because Cyberpunk had 8 years of development, I don't know, probably $100 million budget, and of course a huge team which had experience. And when you think about this, this game had so few resources and it still came out looking great. And yet the bugs will still be there, the problems will still be there, the balancing will still be there. Don't worry, this is how much it takes normally. I get used to it. Act 3. Chapter 3. No matter the odds. But the dialogue is so well written and kind of like the catchphrases. This is basically what they said. The three of them usually said, no matter the odds.
We have to journey north. All the way north. There, the Hellion shall be made whole again. My brethren, the army of truth seekers will join forces with us. We shall march to stop Fury's ascent. One final push that will determine the fate of mankind.
Exactly. A little sound bug here and there, doesn't matter.
What are they doing?
They are actually possessed and they can't help us or won't help us. I mean, just look at this view. And this beautiful dog over here.
What's wrong?
I'm not sure.
We've reached the vault.
Agreed.
We won't find rest. What are they waiting for? Out in the open? And if that does not give you pause, then the yellow smoke should.
What is it?
It means that their halls have been breached. We built a network of caves among the vault's foundations when hostilities with the Republic were at their peak. Fallback shrines in case something went wrong. We should find one of these nearby.
Yes, sadly we will not get any help from them. Anyway, see you next time. Bye.